Well, hi, hello again. Well, I've dug up my old Stuart setup here. I put them on the board, I fixed the boiler to the board, but the engine isn't, because I use this boiler to test and to drive other engines as well. So I just have it on a piece of, I have the engine on a piece of non-slip material here, although it still does slide. Little chuff pot at the back there to catch the exhaust. And anyway, here we go. We'll start off by just boil some water here. Distilled water with a little bit of tap water. That seems to be, I found, probably the best combination. Not much in terms of tap water, but just a bit. Apparently it helps to stop any minor, very minor leaks there might be, presumably by creating a little bit of calcium around the joints, which you wouldn't get with distilled water, of course. So we're just filling this up. Just see the levels start to build up there. Coming up to just above half. We'll give it a little bit more. There, that should do it. My old, trusty old brass funnel here. Old being the word. Put the cap on with the aluminium washer. Give it a bit of a tighten. I know it's not the thing to use, but it fits beautifully on this. Just a gentle tighten. Make sure the steam regulator is shut. Pressure's right. I've got it hooked up to the blowdown here, just in case I need to reset the water level gauge. This I've blocked off because on the inside, temporarily, so I won't be using it today, otherwise it'll leak everywhere. The engine itself, the S50, very nicely made, this one I found. It came in all sorts of colours. I decided to go to play it safe and just painted it all black. I'd probably change my mind at some stage and put something a bit more colourful. Bit of steam oil in the inline oiler. I can get this off. That's a long thread. That should do it. Don't put too much or it'll really steam everything up. Oil everything up, I mean. So here we go, that's done. This I leave open normally and control, regulate the steam from this one here. I've put all the oil in the various places. So that's ready to run now, hopefully. Right, we'll light the burner then. There she goes, in there, more or less in the middle. Turn it up. So that'll take a while. To build up a little bit of steam. So I'll get back to it when steam is more or less available. Well, I think we don't have much steam. We're just coming up to 25 psi, so that should be enough to clear the throat of this thing. Just open very, very gently the regulator there and take in some steam. Here we go, making steam noises now. I just want to clear this. There we go. Just looking to see if there's any steam coming through the exhaust. Yep. There we go. Very smooth. Very quiet. The S50. Rolls Royce of engines, well, at least the engines I have. No clatter, no piston slap, nothing, just smooth as silk, this one. The safety valve is slowly starting to make noises. It won't open till about 60 psi, so it's a long way away from that. Just ticking over there. Running well. You see, you can't see the level. This is why you sometimes have to release some water and steam through this valve to get the water level to work again. There it is. The engine's so quiet you can hardly, you don't realize it's working sometimes. Try and put some light on it, better light, maybe. Seems to be maintaining that 25 psi because I'm running the engine, of course, so plus this burner isn't really big enough for the boiler. If I close this, well, I mean, this, if I switch the gas off completely, take the burner out, and she'll go on working for donkey's years. The trouble is if you open it up anymore, she will start to slide across the board. There you go. And anyway, I prefer to see it running nice and slowly than fast. Those gurgly noises you hear are the steam, the exhaust going into the chuff pot there and making some noise, but you get steam, of course, out of the chimney eventually. Well, there it is. Stewart 501 boiler and the Stewart S50 mill engine running as it should. Okay, give it a rest now. There you go. Thanks for watching.